Hallelujah. While your clapping your hands, just begin to go ahead and tell them thank you for what you're going to do. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Thank you.
Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. There's victory in the name of Jesus. There's hope in the name of Jesus. There's peace in the name of Jesus. There's life in the name of Jesus. There's running in the name of Jesus. There's praise in the name of Jesus. Every need that we need, hallelujah, is in the name of Jesus. Praise God for this morning. When I think about everything that He's done for me this whole week, and how He brought me through, and how He's bringing me through, I promise you, I'm not going to let this day go by without giving Him some praise.
Oh, We'll be right back. Yeah.
If you love somebody this morning, just tell them to say, tell them he's breaking your chains.
He's breaking your chains.
He's breaking your chains.
Break.
Shall we?
Break every chain. Break.
Oh, shut up.
Chain.
Oh, glory.
Break every chain.
Oh.
heaven and earth is gonna pass. That when I get up in the morning, I can feel it.
Hallelujah.
That when I open my eyes, I say, God, I thank you. When I get out my bed, little Jerry, and I'm able to walk, I'm able to talk. I'm able to go to the bathroom. I'm able to bathe myself. I tell him, thank you. Food on the table.
Thank you.
Clothes on my back.
Thank you.
The songwriter said, he said, tragedies are in common places.
Yes.
All types of diseases.
Yes.
People's cousin Beth are slipping away.
Yes.
The economy is going up and down. And people just can't get enough pay.
Come on.
But as for me, all I can say is thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord, for all you've done.
Thank you. Thank you.
If that's you, I just dare you to tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Speaking something this morning, and I want to definitely share it in your hearing. I'm so glad that when I come to church, I can feel him.
Come on now. Come on.
And I'm so glad that when I come to church, I just can't feel him, but you can feel him too.
Yes, yes.
Because I don't know about you, but I didn't come to the valley of dry bones.
Come on now.
When I come where there's lively stones. And if we just get on one accord, God will begin to bless us and give us just what we need.
Yes.
All because we're praising him in a time of this. Amen.
Amen.
On this weekend, we are celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. On last night, some would say that it was Good Friday. They had service, and while we were here, I was here in the church working 12 hours straight, preparing for God to move today, along with myself and our sanctuary pastor, Pastor Glenton, and our church mother, one of our church mothers, Mother Nisi. As things were dusty and as things were messed up and as things were kind of chaotic, and Sister Michaela came out, we begin to just feel this atmosphere with thanksgiving and praise for what he has done, doing for us as a whole. Sometimes God will multiply you just to see if you are in the place or going to get in a place of gratitude that he might give your house more than enough.
Yes.
I'm just talking just a minute just to kind of set some foundation.
Yes.
And out of this scripture, I begin to read some things about the crucifixion And the Lord began to show me some things, and I believe that this will be a blessing to you and a help and a strength to you. Amen.
Amen.
It's definitely good to see each and every person that's here under the sound of my voice. Those that are getting in their rightful positions.
Amen.
And those that are saying, you know what, Pastor, Apostle, I'm going to do what God told me to do.
Yes.
All because there's purpose for me.
Oh, come on now. Yes. Come on.
And because God have called me to pursue my purpose, Brother Brian. I can't look to my left and I can't look to my right. But I got to make sure that when he comes back, Mother,
yes,
that he finds me occupying,
yes, yes,
until he comes.
Yes, yes.
He's not coming back for those that are stagnated,
yes, yes,
that are standing still,
yes,
those that are made, that may be in one place all the time, but he's looking for those that said, I'm looking for my sons and my daughters that's progressing.
Yes.
I'm not going to say that you're going to be perfect, but let me tell you something, but you're moving forward.
Come on, yes, yes, yes,
yes. And I don't know about you, but there's a lot of things in life that could have kept me in the predicament that I was in.
Yes. Yes.
But let me tell you something, when you make up in your mind and say, you know what, I can't stay like this any longer.
Yes.
You said hell or high water, people, places, a thing. Guess what? If I got to leave you, I just got to leave you, because guess what? Greater is calling for
you. Yes. Yes.
And I don't know about you this morning, but the Lord is calling us higher.
Yes. Come on now. Come on.
He's calling. He's calling us to greater.
Yes.
And he's calling us deeper, and he's calling us wider.
Yes.
That's why he told her, he said, glory to God, hallelujah, he said, glory to God, Jabez said, he said, I pray that you will enlarge my territory. I want you to enlarge, glory, I'm going to enlarge my tent, I'm going to enlarge my pigs, because guess what? What is prepared and what I see right now is not big enough to house what you're going to give me. Whatever, glory to God, and where I'm going, hallelujah, I want more space to fill up. I want more space to fill more Jesus. I don't know about you, glory to God, but I dare you to touch that name and say, I need a little bit more Jesus.
I need a little bit more Jesus.
Glory to God, hallelujah, because he want to take me to that desired place that,
yes,
he has called,
yes,
me to.
Yes.
Hallelujah, glory to God. And I don't know about you, hallelujah, but I'm waiting for the Lord to fill me,
yes,
with what he has designed to give.
Yes. Come on.
So in this, glory to God, this weekend, he began to tell me, he said, glory to God, and you got that scripture that I told you to read this morning. Glory to God. He told me, he said, hallelujah, as we prepare, glory to God, in these last 3 days, mama, he said, they were preparing me for my crucifixion. And while they was preparing me for my crucifixion, he said, I dwelt in my hometown.
Yes, yes.
In Jerusalem.
Yes.
Where my friends and my family was going to be the one to crucify me.
Yes, yes.
It wasn't going to be those that I did not know, but it was going to be those things that were so familiar with me,
yeah,
that they could not determine what was left and what was right and what was good and what was bad.
Yeah.
But I was going to have to be rejected in my own home.
Come
on. Abraham now tells us in the book of Genesis, he said, first of all, he said, I was one of the first that the Lord told me, he said, get amongst your kindred, get from amongst your country, glory to God, because those that are around you are familiar with what, glory to God, familiar with what, hallelujah, with you and what I'm about to do for you, they're not going to be able to understand.
Right. Yes.
They're not going to be able to perceive or, glory to God, be able to, glory to God, hallelujah, come to a realization what I want to do and how I want to do.
Yes.
And glory to God, I don't know about you, but I prophesy and I speak to you that God is going to bless you in some uncommon, in some unusual ways,
yes,
that people cannot.
Yes.
It don't got nothing to do with your money. It don't got nothing to do with your credit. It don't got nothing to do with your health. It don't got nothing to do with what you got in your house. It don't got nothing to do with your boss. It don't got nothing to do with what your children is doing. It don't matter what your spouse can do and what they can't do. But it's called an unusual blessing. Glory to God, that your enemies cannot determine, and they don't know which way it's going to come. But the scripture says, he said, I'm going to open up the window of heaven and pour out a blessing that you won't even have room enough to receive it. Because guess what? My ways are not your ways, and my thoughts They're not.
Hallelujah.
They're not your thoughts.
Hallelujah.
So he said, I'm now in a place where I'm preparing for crucifixion.
Come on now.
Now I must let Peter deny me.
Come on now.
These are not just people that I don't know, but these are people that I'm breaking bread with.
Come on now. Right now.
Watch yourself.
Oh,
right now.
Sister Charmaine. Sometimes we may be breaking bread with people that don't like us, but guess what?
Watch
we must
yourself.
Stay right there and watch right God there. Prepare that table
right
in the presence
there.
Of our enemies
yeah.
so that they can
yeah.
see the unusual blessing. Because
watch
guess what? Hallelujah. God don't want you to escape the scene. He wants you to stay on the scene.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Glory to yourself. God. And sometimes what happens is he said, I want you to wait till Peter, glory to God, Peter going to, glory to God, deny you. And Judas is going to betray
come on
you.
Now. Jesus. Hey.
He's going to thank betray you. And glory to God, will you let me tell a story this morning?
Come on,
he said, glory to God, he said, Judas is going to betray you. And I don't want you to, glory to God, Sister McCain, I don't want you to stop Judas. Because guess what? Prophecy must be fulfilled.
Come on.
And see, sometimes what's happening is we want prophecy ought to be the good, but sometimes prophecy is also mixed with the bad, because he said, for we know all things work together for the good that love the Lord. And if they are called, they're called according to his purpose. If I told you, the bad is coming against you, guess what? You must be designed for purpose. The bad is coming against you, you must be designed for good. You must be designed for you up for
oh,
he said glory to God. He said Judas
Jesus.
He said Judas Jesus. Is going to betray, but don't you dismiss him, because he got a job to do.
He got a job to do
sons and daughters. And I know sometimes it don't feel good, sometimes it is frustrating, sometimes it's stressful, sometimes you do want to throw in the towel. Yes, I'm talking from experience. I'm trying to help you this morning. Sometimes you say, you know what, I don't feel like doing it today. I felt like doing it yesterday, but today I don't feel like doing it today. Lord, I'm not saying I'm not saved, but I just don't feel like doing it today. I don't feel like praising them, because sometimes it's a little cloudy, it's a little smoky, it's a little foggy. But sometimes I just can't see my way. I can't see the light from day. I can't see, glory, out the cracking in the clouds with the sun beaming down. I just can't see because the rain is too much. Glory, God, but Judas must fulfill his assignment.
Yes.
He now tells them, glory to God. He said, now I want Judas to fulfill himself in the book of the first book of the chapter Acts. Glory to God. And guess what? I'm going to put this nugget. The only way, glory to God, the only way that an apostolic and a prophetic church, I'm going to jump right back. The only way an apostolic and a prophetic church can stand unless Judas come gets it.
Wow.
And sometimes, glory to God, hallelujah. See, glory to God, it ain't people that's coming against you. It's that spirit.
It's that spirit.
Glory, that spirit of not just of Judas, but that spirit of Peter, of denial, betrayal,
my
of
God,
glory, God, of rejection,
God.
Of abandonment. That wants to come against you, glory God, because it says if I can, glory God, benefit, or if I can cause you, glory God, to slow up from getting your purpose, guess what? Glory God, I can begin to speak to your mind to cause you to look back like Lot's wife did. Glory God, hallelujah. But guess what? If something keeps speaking to you and say, keep going, I encourage you, I strengthen you, I'm causing you to have power. Glory God, I'm causing you to have determination, all because there's something in front of you. The only way you're going to survive, unless you go through the tough times, Lord, unless you go through, Lord, sometimes where you don't feel like going, where you make yourself get up and go, where you get yourself up, Lord, you do your hair, you get your clothes on, you put your shoes on, you put your makeup on, and so you know what, I can't stay right here, because guess what, hallelujah, there's people looking for me. He said creation is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of, there is an army that's rising, there is a culture of people that's going to rise out of their ashes. There is a culture of people that's going to come out of their grave clothes, that's going to come out the graveyard and say, you're looking for me? And guess what? I'm dusting myself off. Oh my God, I'm polishing myself. Glory, you're not looking at the final production yet. You're not looking at the final, glory, the final thing yet. But guess what? I'm getting myself together, because you're waiting on me, because guess what? Your deliverance is in my mouth. Your breakthrough is in my mouth. What you need is in me.
Yeah.
He said, glory to God. He's getting back. He's said, get back. He said, Judas. He said, Judas, glory to God. Judas is going to, glory, he's going to do this. He said, but in the next chapter, the next couple of verses, not chapters later, but just a couple verses later, yeah, yeah. He said, but I replaced Judas, glory God, with Matthias. And what the Holy Ghost is saying right now,
come on.
You let Judas do his job and get out of the way, there is a replacement that's standing right there.
Hey!
I don't know about you right now, but you said, glory to God, I lost some things,
yes,
I lost some friends, I lost some places,
yes.
I lost some things, but guess what, count it all, Joe.
Yeah.
But I hear the Holy Ghost saying, glory, your replacement is standing right next to you. All you got to do is let Judas do his job and let him do his work in his assignment. And when he do his job, he can go on. Because it says, glory, God, in the couple verses, he said before he could be replaced, he had to commit suicide. Oh, hallelujah.
Watch
and what's happening to you right now, you trying to fight your enemies when it's already designed for them to fight themselves and commit suicide. Fight them. You don't got to go and talk about them. You don't got to go and send, go and hallelujah, smoke stuff. You don't got to send Facebook messages and try to talk subliminal messages. But guess what? Let them do their work. Because guess what? When they commit suicide, the replacement is going to step right in.
Hey!
And so you know what? Going, I was just waiting right on the sideline for the old rebound. And guess what? I'm not saying, go out, these people, these things in these places, they don't feel cheated because they just waiting for their opportunity. And sometimes some of us are in a place right now, glory out, where there's some things, glory out, and we're even waiting for our opportunity for God to get the glory. But while you're in the waiting room, while you're in that waiting place, while you're in that waiting posture, the Holy Ghost is saying, just stand there and be a good courage. And I'm going to strengthen your heart while you're waiting. You may be in the hallway. You may be standing right there outside the door. But guess what? Just like your permit is on that door, like I said last week, it's permitted for you to come through and come in.
Yeah.
And I come and let somebody know this morning that either though you're standing right there on the side, the Holy Ghost is saying you next in line. Hallelujah. And I'm just kind of paraphrasing it while we don't have to read so much. But what happens now, they got Jesus. They got him. Glory to God. Hallelujah. They got him. I need your help right quick, Elder Cynthia. Glory to God. There's a t-shirt. T-shirt just is backwards. It's backwards. Just leave it just like that. Glory to God. He now. Hallelujah. You don't mind if I just do a little something.
Come on.
He said, glory to God. He said, now they are coming and there is Jesus and there's two thieves.
All right, nice.
They're not perfect people.
Amen.
They're not great people, but they're thieves.
Come on. Yeah.
Oh, see, that's just it's the proof to you that, glory to God, you don't got to be so great to be around Jesus.
Yeah.
Can't get around.
Yeah.
You don't got to be so puffed up and so high and so holy that you can't get a hold of Jesus.
Yeah.
And I want to let somebody know, I don't care how low you walk in this morning, the Holy Ghost said, guess what? I want you to come to me.
Yeah.
I didn't call you to the apostle. I didn't call you to the pastor. I didn't call you to the mothers. I didn't call you to the elders or the ministers. I didn't call you to the brothers and sisters, but I call you to me. All because, glory to God, I'm the one that specializes in doing things that are impossible. They now march Jesus, glory to God, and just follow me while I'm in the Word of God. They now follow Jesus, glory to God, and bring him to the hill of Golgotha. Glory to God, it means, glory to God, the place of the skull. The dead thing. Glory to God, and what happens now? Glory to God, they put him on a pole. They put his two thieves on on a pole. And one, glory God, one said, glory God, on one hand, he said, glory God, if you are the Son of God, why don't you just prove yourself and get us down? Glory to God. And then the other one said, you know what, Lord, glory to God, and I'm just trying to paint a picture. You're listening to the foolishness, but I just want to tell you this. When you get in paradise, I want you to remember me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And when you begin to study history, paradise was not the place of heaven. Glory to God. But paradise was located, and hear me, it was located in the suburb of hell.
Come on.
It was located in the suburb of hell. Glory to God. All because, glory to God, God, before me, he was going to have to go to paradise just for one thing. Glory to God. So now, hallelujah, they began, glory to God, he said, glory to God, I need you to, glory to God, go and break the thieves' bones. So now they break their bones, glory to God, because life is in the bones. And so when life is in the bones, and they break your bones, that means you are now into a dead state. So now they get to Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Just open it up because I'm going to turn, I'm putting it on. They now, glory to God, they begin to, glory to God, they begin to, glory to God, get to Jesus.
All right now.
Somebody clap your hands. They begin to get to Jesus. Give me those markers. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory. Come on, Pastor. Glory. Open that marker. Glory to God. They now get to Jesus. And what happens when they get to Jesus? Glory to God. They begin to, hallelujah, before they got put him on the cross, though, they begin to beat him. Yes. Glory to God. And what I want you to do, I want you to write hurt. Glory to God. And now, glory to God, they begin to keep whooping them. I want you to write pain. Glory to God. And they keep on beating them. I want you to write lack. L-A-C-K.
Yes, Lord.
Glory, they begin to put lack, glory to God, and they kept beating them, and then they begin to beat them for rejection.
My God.
And then what happens is they now begin to beat them, glory to God, because guess what? Hallelujah. He had to, glory to God, feel what we felt. How can he lift us and bring alive something that he did not go through himself? I'm gonna bring you out of sin. And I'm not gonna stop there, but then I'm gonna bring you out of death.
Yes.
Oh my God.
My Lord.
My God, Jesus.
And not just the, And now what happens is, glory to God, the grave. without the shedding of blood. There is no remission. See, if he didn't shed his blood, he would have to walk around with all this.
Come on. Hallelujah.
See what happens is, see, he was ripped because there was something inside of him.
Wow.
That was waiting to poke out. And some of you, you got to stay right there because there's something that's going to
shake. Hey! Come on!
I want you to tell them that this is from Jesus with love.
Wow.
This is why the Holy Ghost, I don't know if some of you read the sign, but the Holy Ghost, he said, put church of love.
Come on.
He said, to remind each and every one of you that when you walk in here, that I'm giving you love because I love you with the everlasting love. So I need you to be commissioned when you leave here to love somebody. I shed my blood. Oh. Cross one out.
Jesus.
I got
it.
Cross one out. Cross one out.
So now,
he's in a they begin to beat him. They said blood and water came streaming down. But said when he gave up the ghost, they said they took him down. And put him in a borrowed tomb. Meaning where I'm going to put you. It don't belong to you. But belongs to him. We'll be on the way. But you got to go through the process. Where you go. So now they said, glory to God. Wait, look, give me some more sheep. Oh, now. They begin to wrap them up.
Come on now.
Begin to wrap them all up. Because guess what? He got sin. He done took on sin.
Took it out.
Thank you, Jesus. Right
now. He said the Lord ain't never sinned. Oh, yes, he did. Because he took your sin out. He had to become you. And if you said you was a raggedy, wretched, messed up, tore up from the floor, guess what? Just how you was is how he was. Said, glory to God, hallelujah. When they wrapped them up, glory to God, they begin to roll the stone in the way.
Yes.
And said, but when he got in there by himself, there is a, glory to God, a place and a state that you got to begin to get in the middle of.
Yeah.
Mother Mary. Many of us call her Mother Mary because she became daughter.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yes.
She looking in the angel saying, what you looking for?
Yes, Lord.
Who you looking for?
Yes.
Because who you looking for?
Yes.
He done risen.
Wow. Yes. Wow.
Just like he said he would.
Yes. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes.
He's risen like he said he would.
Yes.
And said, but when he got in around him,
Jesus.
He said, wait. I know you see me.
Yes.
He said, because I got to ascend to the Father.
Yes.
And I got to go tell the disciples.
Yes.
Watch yourself.
That all is well.
Watch yourself.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
My God. My God.
Yes.
He said, but what I want you to do,
yes.
I know you don't agree with women preachers.
Yeah.
And I know you don't agree with women pastors. But guess what?
Yes.
That's when your assignment
stepped
into play.
Wow.
Yes.
And he said, what I want you to do is go back and tell them I'm alive.
Yes.
And I'm waiting.
Yes.
And say, we have overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word. Royce!
Yes.
But the Holy Ghost freed you up as you were coming out.
I tell somebody we're going to give God.
The Lord said, those that need it, those that want it, I'm giving you the power to rise out of your mind. Because everything on here, on the outside, you may be free from it, but your mind ain't got free yet.
Come on now.
And the Holy Ghost said, he said, I won't allow you to go through prison in your mind, making you feel like there is no hope. When the Lord said, he said, but I gave you hope.
Yes.
He said, I gave you a future. Plans to prosper you. And bring you, Jeremiah 29:11, to an expected end.
Yes.
If that's you, I'm not going to carry on. But if that's you, when I touch you, there's going to be a transaction from heaven that's going to cause your mind to be free from some depression or relief. I hear the Holy Ghost said, he said, and some, I hear the Lord said, he said, and this going to, it caused you to escape some headaches, migraines, and I even hear the Lord even says, he said, even the rupturing of blood vessels in your brain to cause you to have an aneurysm. Somebody in here been having some strong migraines. The Holy Ghost said, and it's been tapping into the popping of blood vessels for you to have an aneurysm. So the Lord said, he said, I'm going to cancel, whoever that is, he said, I'm canceling death off you right now. Hey! Now, bless you. If you need this, just come on. Come on. Come on.
Finally, at the next level, where the Holy Ghost is Yeah.
If you heard the Lord say something right quick, come. If you hear the Lord speaking to you and he wants you to release it in the atmosphere, come right quick. Release it. You got to release it.
When I was running earlier, the Lord said the finish line. The finish line is yet ahead.
Lord said, we're passing the finish line. Anybody else? Come on, that's you. Come on.
Newness and wholeness is what God spoke to me.
Finish line, newness and wholeness. Anybody else?
She can't miss. I know.
Anybody else? Oh,
thank you.
Really, I saw just pieces everywhere. And the Lord began to speak to me and said, check yourself. Because, see, if you have pieces of you after, the Lord said, I want everything. I want all of it. The Lord said, stop giving me pieces.
Somebody got to carry on.
Oh, Jesus.
Anybody else?
The song, the battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord.
There is no hurt that Jesus can heal. There is no pain he cannot feel. But all things were according to the Master's purpose and his holy will. For the battle is not yours, it's the Lord.
Seconds, just thank God for what God just released over us. Thank you, Jesus. God, we thank you for what you have done this day, in this time, in this moment. Seal it amongst the believers. Victory deliverance. We give your name all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. Jesus Christ. Thank God for those that are on Facebook Live. We definitely want to welcome you to Radical Nation. The new Radical Nation Deliverance Cathedral. Perry, Florida 32348, the Church of Love. Lord God, we want to definitely welcome you here. Lord God, from also our sanctuary, Pastor Carl Glanton. Lord God, we thank you that you have logged in, Lord God, and pray that this service has been a blessing to you. Lord God, you can so see at Cash App Believers Covenant. Also, you can go to the website at CoryNealMinistries.org. Again, CoryNealMinistries.org. There's a giving tab, and we thank you for your giving. Within your giving, Lord God, since we have been in this building, we have put a roof. Lord God, we have put on the new ceiling, lights. Glory God, different things. Glory God, and we thank you for, Lord God, what you have contributed, Lord God, and for your prayers. Glory God, come and visit with us next Saturday at 12 noon. We will be back, glory God, hallelujah, for our church anniversary, 6 years. Glory God, and our building dedication. Glory God, with Bishop Stanley Roundtree and also Bishop, glory God, Channing Jackson. Glory God, we are going to have a phenomenal time. Normally we start at 11, but again, we're at 12 p.m. Glory God, so we definitely want you to come and join us. Log again, we're on Facebook Live, and I promise you, your soul will be blessed. Somebody come on and give God a hand up. Praise God.